God, this is Julie. Is Dan there? Can you put Dan on the line?
Oh, hello, Julie. Let me make sure that Mr. Tishner is available.
You see, I got this new literature here. It's a skinny bitch.
Oh, in the kitsch?
Yeah.
Oh.
Mr. Tishner, your wife is on the line. It sounds urgent.
Oh, it sounds urgent. Tell her I'm out to lunch.
Do you want me to take a message?
Yeah, tell me what she says and I'll call her back as soon as my buzz wears off, if you know what I mean.
Alright, Mr. Tishner. Miss Tishner?
Yes, hello?
Hello, ma'am. It seems that Mr. Tishner is out to lunch. May I take a message for you?
Oh, it figures, that fat bastard. Okay, tell him that I passed out and when I woke up, the house was robbed.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, and Dan Jr. is missing.
Oh, my heavens.
Oh, and I'm not sure, but I think I might have been raped.
Heavens to Betsy, dear. I will try to contact Mr. Tishner right away.
Please do. I'd say have him call me at home, but I'm pretty sure the phone is liquid now. And I'd say have him call me on my cell phone, but I have a hunch it was stolen during the raping.
I'm sure once he is aware of the situation, he will find a way to contact you.
Let's hope he does. Okay, thank you. Take care.
Okay, bye!
Hey bro, watch this.
Oh, you're talking about those service clowns, right?
Yeah.
The seals.
Mr. Tishner?
What?
This better be good.
Your wife has informed me of some terrible news.
What terrible news?
Well, your house has been robbed and burnt down. Your son is missing. And apparently, your wife may be a victim of rape.
Is that all?
Oh, God, sweetheart. I thought you were going to tell me she used all my money.
She wants to contact you right away.
Yeah, I'll mess something out. Thanks, darling.
Well, you're welcome, Mr. Tishner. Dan Tishner's office, Joan on the line!
Hey, Joan, it's Marty. Could you put Dan on?
Let me see if he's available. Mr. Tishner, Marty is on the line.
Oh, stellar!
Wow, cutie pie. You're looking great today.
Oh, Mr. Tishner, maybe you should take the call.
Maybe you should stop being so fine.
Marty, what's up?
Hey, Dan, I had an amazing time with Keisha last night, but I don't know how to tell her I want to get to the next step in the relationship.
Alright, well, first off, Pudgy, you take her out to a nice place, feed her food from your fork and or spoon, then you say to her, I wish that spoon was my penis, and that your mouth was your butt. If she reacts negatively, you just say, you must have misunderstood me, and then make something up. Worked with Julie.
Thanks, Dan.
Listen, I'm here anytime you need me, kid. Alright? Alright, see you. You know, Goins, you can wear something a little bit more friendlier to the office, if you catch my drift. Come on, Pat, let's go back to the office.
Tishner's office, Joan speaking.
Hello, this is Martha Spinier, Stan Tishner's employer. May I speak for him for a moment?
Hold on a moment. No, no. Mr. Tishner, it's Martha's Vineyard.
Damn it, hang up on her. We'll tell her it's a faulty landline.
Hey, Miss Goins. It's Craig. Can I talk to Dan?
Oh, sure, Craig. Let me see if he's available. Mr. Tishner, it's Craig.
Finally, put me on the line. Oh, hey, Craig, what's up?
Hey, man. Just called to let you know that I robbed your house and burned it down.
That was you?
Yep, it was me.
Well, you crazy kook, you have to tell me how you did it.
Well, I walked into your house to return that movie that you lent me. And then I found your wife Julie passed out after I had learned the fact that it was easy for me to steal some of your cooler shit.
Oh, you don't say.
Yeah, and then, you know, I was cooking some pizza and decided to leave the oven on. You know, just to add a little kick to the punch.
Yum, pizza. Sounds good. So, did you rape my wife too?
Would you be mad if I did?
As hell, but it's all in good fun, of course.
Yeah, well, I didn't. The bitch is probably just flattering herself.
And what about Dan Jr.? Where's he?
Oh, I took him with me. Lured him out of the house with promises of ice cream.
Ice cream?
Well, of course he didn't really get any ice cream. You know me, I can't really afford it.
So what's he doing now?
Oh, he's taking a nap in the trunk of my car. He was crying a little bit when I first put him in there, but I guess he tired himself out.
Oh, that sounds like my son. He gets all worked up and then he can barely keep his eyes open.
Well, I'll let you get back to work.
I have to say, you bested me today, but don't you think I'll try and get you back.
I'm looking forward to it. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Wow, I mean, LOL.
Joan, hold all my calls for the rest of today.